Hi guys. All right, we'll get started here. So I'm gonna be leading you guys through a mat Pilates class today. You don't need any equipment except for your mat and yourself, or you can lay on a carpet, whatever you have available. And just a quick little reminder that viewers watching today, only follow along at what feels comfortable for your body. So take it at your pace if you need to, but we'll get started here. So how does this music sound for everybody? Does it sound good? Give me a thumbs up if you're ready to go. All right, so we're gonna get started here. So go ahead and come on over here to your mat. We're gonna sit down here. Feet are gonna be hip width distance apart. You're sitting on your mat. Arms are gonna extend straight out in front of you. We wanna warm up here, so you're gonna slowly roll down one vertebrae at a time and then sit all the way back up. So slowly roll down and then rolling all the way back up to that top position. So rolling on down and rolling on back up. Slowly roll down and then lift all the way back up. So you wanna roll it down and up. Really trying to get that spine mobile here. Mobile spine is a healthy spine in Pilates. On this next one, you're gonna hold halfway down in a C-curve position. One arm lifts to your head, back down, then other arm back down. As you take this, you wanna think about exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale. So in Pilates, they talk a lot about breath. If you get lost with the breath, A-okay, just follow along, and as long as you're breathing, it works. Option here, if you want a little challenge, to take both arms at the same time. So you exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale. Keep that going, lifting, lowering, breathing. Last two. On this next one, go ahead and hold those arms extended. You're gonna slowly roll down to your back and then lift right back on up. So slowly roll down and lift all the way back up. Slowly roll down and then lift all the way back up. As you do this, think about the exhale on the way up and inhale as you lower down. Take two more here. And on this next one, you're gonna go ahead and meet at the bottom of that mat, laying all the way on down. I'm gonna just check if music's sounding good for everybody. Everybody good here? All right, we're gonna go ahead. On your mat, one leg pulls up to tabletop, plant it down, lifting, planting. As you do this, you wanna make sure that you keep that lumbar spine imprinted into the mat. Now, if this is not enough of a challenge for you here, we're gonna go ahead and bring both legs to tabletop and take them at the same time. So you think, inhale, exhale. As you do this, try to keep those knees to a 90 degree angle so you really feel that core working. Last two. On this next one, hold the legs into this tabletop position, which is shins parallel to the floor and the knees at a 90 degree angle bend. Hands go behind the head, elbows wide, and you're gonna go ahead and inhale here. Exhale, curl up, inhale, pause, and then exhale, lower back down. Breathing as you do this, you wanna take a breath at the top so you really know that you're controlling that, and then core is engaging. If this is too much for you, no worries. Just put your feet onto the mat. Again, remember to take it at your pace. Last one. On this next one, you're gonna go ahead and relax it down here. Curl those legs back to that tabletop. Hands go on to one knee here. Other leg's gonna extend straight out here. From here, you wanna pulse two times in, exhale, and then inhale as you switch those legs. Exhale again, switch. Keep that going. Trying to keep the scapula lifted off that mat. How's everybody doing here? I see a bunch of hearts, so that must be good. Last one. And bring the legs tabletop, lower down. Take a little bit of a breather. So we're gonna go into 100. In Pilates, that means we try to stay lifted for 100 breaths. You're gonna pull your legs up to that tabletop position. Arms go directly overhead. Take a big inhale here. Exhale, curl yourself up, hands just above the mat. Inhale, pause. And then exhale, begin to pump these arms for 5 counts. And then inhale in for 5. As you do this, you want the breath to match those arms. So you wanna think, exhale out. Inhale in. Trying to feel that core working. The same amount of space that you have between your chin and the chest, you want to keep it there. So you don't want to feel that neck stress. Give a little bit of space. If this is not challenging enough, you have the option to extend legs out on that diagonal, or you can keep them on in. It's up to you. Keep that going. Breathing. You got a few more. Last couple. And go ahead and float all the way back down. Take a little breather here. Feet are planted into that mat. Arms are above your head. If you want more of a challenge, extend the legs long or keep them bent if you want assistance. Go ahead and curl yourself up, rolling all the way to that upright position, and then rolling all the way back down, and then rolling back up. When you get up, just stop where your shoulders are right over your hips, and then back down from there. Keep that going. Last one. On this next one, hold it on up. Just that right arm opens out to the side, back in, other arm out, and back in. Take it two more times, really feeling those obliques engaging. Last set. And then go ahead and take a little bit of a breather. All right, we're going to a side plank here. So do what's best for your body. I'm going to my elbow. So my shoulder's over my elbow, elbow in line with the wrist. And then my knees are in line with that midline as well. Hand can be on the mat for assistance, or you can have it on your hip. Up to you. Go ahead and float those hips off and just breathe here. Breathing, trying to imagine an invisible line running from your head, through your shoulders, all the way down to your knees. And then option for a challenge to float this top knee off. From here, you're just holding. Breathing here. And then begin to take that knee. So you want to tap it down and lift. And lift. Inhale, exhale. So Pilates, we talk a lot about breath. If you're getting confused with when to inhale or exhale, just breathe. Last one. Holding that leg lifted, extend it straight out. Arm reaches in front. Your elbow pulls to your midline as your knee pulls in, and then both straighten. So you think exhale, pull, inhale, extend. Knee and elbow, straighten. Exhale, inhale. Breathing. Really feeling that underneath oblique working along with that glute. Exhale, inhale. Breathing as you do this for 4, 3, 2, 1. Hold it here. Option to just float that leg up an inch, down an inch. Last couple for 4, 3, 2, 1. Relax it on down. All right, we're going to our elbows here. So elbow is holding us up, both hands behind the head here. Legs can be fully straight, or you could have the underneath one bent in for a little bit of support. I like that the best. From here, you're lifting the top leg up, bringing that leg just in front of the hip. So exhale as you pull it forward, and then inhale as you pull back. Exhale forward, inhale back. Try to keep that leg up at that hip height. How's everyone doing? Keep that going. Exhale, inhale. On this next one, hold that leg back to the midline and you just lift it up, up. As you're holding it here, you should feel your shoulder stabilizing, so you're working that shoulder as well. Breathing for 4, 3, 2, 1. Tap to the floor, lift all the way up. Tapping, lifting, drop and lift. You should feel that shoulder working, your oblique engaged. Last one, hold that leg up and you pull knee into chest, extend. Pull in, extend for 4, 3, just 2 left, last 2. Last one, and go ahead and relax it down. All right, stretching that leg out, you can go to your elbows here. The leg that was just working, cross it over the other leg and just get a little stretch there. Figure 4, if this is too intense, again, take it at your pace. You can always lay down. It takes a little release off of it there. All right, we're gonna go ahead and lay on over to our stomach. So you're laying stomach first on the ground here. Hands are right underneath your shoulders. You want to work through those back extensors. So you're inhaling, lifting chest off the floor, and then exhale, lower down. Again, only go to what feels best for your body. You know your body best, so try not to force anything. Inhale up, exhale down. On this next one, you're gonna go ahead and hold lifted. Right arm extends, left leg lifts, and then switch. Left arm lifts, right leg lifts. Taking tiny little swims here. So in Pilates, you wanna work on this cross coordination and then really work on stabilizing through that trunk. So breathing, inhale, exhale, swimming for 4, 3, 2, 1. Relax it down. Go ahead and sit on up to that rest position. Arms reach long. Just get a little release there. All right, how's everybody going? Good news is one side is done. We've got one more to go. So we're gonna go ahead and switch that second side. So starting here, shoulders directly over elbow, elbows in line with the wrist, and you're gonna have knees in line with everything. Float yourself on up here. Holding this position, you're just gonna hold it here. Breathing, inhale, exhale. Float that top leg off. Still trying to keep this underneath side lifted. Holding it here, then just pulse it up. Little pulse and pulse. Keep that going. Last few. On this next one, we extend that leg straight out. Top arm extends as well. So your knee pulls in as your elbow pulls back. And then re-extend straight. So pull, extend. Exhale, inhale. Exhale, inhale. Keep that going. Exhale, inhale. Breathing as you do it helps. Last couple. On this next one, holding that leg extended straight. Just hold, hold, up and up. Little lifts for 4 more. And go ahead and rest it on down. Take a little pause. We're switching to our elbows. So hands go behind the head, elbows are wide here. Again, you can have legs straight or little assistance, bend that bottom knee underneath. Top leg extends forward. Exhale as you pull forward. And then inhale, pull back. So exhale, pull forward. And then inhale back. Keep it going. Trying to keep that leg up at that hip height. Shoulders also lifted so you're not sinking there. Last couple. On this next one, go ahead and hold that leg back to that midline. Just lift it up, little lifts. Lift. You're almost there. Keep it lifting. Holding here. You're tapping to the floor and lifting. So it taps down, then lifts. Taps and lifts. Last few. Couple more. On this next one, just pulse it up to finish here, tiny little pulses. And then you're pulling knee into your chest here. So you're pulling that all the way in. So it's in, extend. Pull in, extend. All the way in. Trying to get to that full range of motion. Last two. And go ahead and take a little rest. Lay on your back, stretch that second side out. So that leg that you were just working, it crosses on over. Again, if this is too intense for you, just lay down, take it at your pace. Getting a nice stretch here. All right, you guys made it through a second side. We're gonna go into a plank series next. So I'll walk you through some variations. If you need to take a break, take a break. It's up to you to take it at your pace here. So you're gonna set yourself up, hands underneath your shoulders, and then extend the legs straight back. Just hold this straight plank position. Keep the scapula pulled apart, really extended here. Just breathing, it helps. As you're breathing here, you're gonna go ahead and begin to add the variation on rocking your heels forward and rocking them back. So my heels just shift forward and back there. Tiny little shifts. Really feeling that core work a little bit harder. For 4, 3, 2, hold it here. Option to lift that right leg up and just hold and breathe. Try to keep those hip bones equal. Few more seconds for 4, 3, plant it down, switch left side lifts. Just hold, hold, last couple counts. And rest it on down. Take a little pause. All right, we're going to a twist here. So shoulders directly over your wrist. And then you're gonna have your knees just bent. Your top foot is in front. From here, you wanna think, inhale, lift up to a side plank. Everything's stacked. Exhale, twist your arm through, hips pike up. Inhale, back open, and then drop it back down. So lifting it on up, pulling it through, open it back up, and drop back down. Taking two more here. Last one. Good news is, one side is done. You just got one side left. So go ahead and switch it on over to that second side. Same thing here, shoulder right over the wrist. You're floating yourself on up, twisting through, hips pike up, and then open back up, drop it down. Taking it at your pace. Two more like this if you can. Last one after this. Remember to breathe, it helps. And then go ahead and rest it on down. All right, we got final plank of the day here. Setting yourself back up, you're going to that plank position. Shoulders over your wrist, legs extend. From here, all you do is lift your hips up to a pike and then back down to a plank. So in Pilates, you want to think about pulling hips to ceiling and dropping back down. Last one. And hold it here, plant your heels down. Feel a little stretch in those calves. Walk your feet all the way on in. Bend the knees, slowly roll up, one vertebrae at a time. Shoulders roll back, and you guys made it. Thanks for joining me today. Follow along for some more activities happening.